Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Ancient Psycho, and this video is a part of a follow-up to the previous commentary that I did, like the whole CGL Season 2 Afterthoughts or something like that. This video is going to be a response to, or how should I put this? I'm making this video because earlier today, as I was checking the comments, as I was checking the comments to my most recent video, the recording of our clan or our CGL team, Team Penis, versus V Secret, the clan V Secret for week 7 of season 2 of CGL Combat Arms, and I was just scrolling through the comments, and I noticed that a lot of the comments were like, you've lost every single game. How does that feel? You suck, bitch. You suck, nerd. Get a life, fucker. Something along those lines. You guys probably know. You guys can probably scroll through the comments for yourselves and see those kinds of things. And I just want to make a quick kind of response video to those people, and those comments in particular, because, honestly, it kind of ticked me off. I'm not gonna lie. It kind of really pissed me off just how fucking ignorant those kinds of people can be. And I'll explain to you why. So strap in your seatbelts, because this is going to be a bumpy-ass ride, because I'm going to be flaming people left and right. Anyways. So, like I said, I've already given you guys context, people leaving comments saying, oh, you guys suck, you guys lost every single game, haha, how does it feel? The thing you need to understand, guys, is from here on out, I'm going to be addressing the haters specifically. The thing that you guys clearly fail to understand is that we're a new team. If I hadn't made that very clear already, it better be clear to you guys now. And if it's still not clear to you, then you must be borderline autistic. But we're a new team. Like I said, we are a very, very new team. All of us in my clan are pretty much new to CGL. I mean, I'm sure some of our other teammates have participated in CGL leagues before. Maybe they've been a part of the competitive community for a lot longer than I may know about, because I didn't really, ask them in depth about it. But, for the most part, it seemed like a lot of us were new to the whole CGL environment, and me especially, because, I might have played, Woggle and Icog back in the day, but it was nowhere near the level of, what I did for Season 2 of CGL with my teammates over at Team Penis. But, we were still a new team. No matter how good your individual skill is, I could be the best fucking pub stomper as Combat Arms has ever known. But that doesn't mean that once I join a CGL team, I'm just gonna start dominating people left and right just because I'm really good at shooting people. It doesn't work that way exactly. CGL is basically, CGL is mostly about teamwork, and mostly about, if your team is better at rotation, if your team is better at knowing how to get picks, knowing the nade spots, the nerd nade spots, as I like to call it, but if your team knows in general more about how to play as a team than your team does, chances are they're gonna be more likely to win than you are. And I'm not saying that our team sucked, like, team-wise. I think our teamwork was really good for the kind of team that we were, newly formed. We had never played with one another before. Like, I only knew Tanner before I joined Team Penis, because, Tanner had done YouTube back in the day. For a little while, anyway. And, At first I was like, one of the problems I see here for my team is that how am I going to, work with these guys? Will there be conflicts between me and some of the guys? Will there be problems that arise as far as team is concerned? Thankfully, everyone was cool. Everyone, we all worked well with each other. There might have been times where, relations were being grinded a little bit. But the next day, we all come back in high spirits and say, hey, we're down to scrim again. Come on, let's go. But the thing is that the point I'm trying to get across is that even despite our really good teamwork, it's still not enough. All these other really experienced teams, of course, I'm just generalizing here, so I don't really know if this pertains to every veteran CGL clan out there. But I'd imagine that their starting lineup, even their backups, have probably played with each other, have practiced together as a team, or at least have had practicing experience with it, even if it were to be with other teams or other players, for much longer than we ever had, let alone me myself. I usually play by myself in pub matches. Very rarely do I play with other people, like, other YouTubers and whatnot, like Sniff and Arctic, but this is my first time. This is basically my first time getting together and getting a team environment on a regular basis with communication and working as a solid team. All these other teams, they have months, maybe even years under their belts over us as far as that's concerned. So for a game like Combat Arms, like I said, that's very team-based, like teamwork-oriented more so than maybe almost any other competitive FPS out there. To me anyway, it's not like it's a big surprise that we lost every single map. Maybe there have definitely been games where if we had clutched up better, if we had performed better, all of us on an individual level, or we could have taken those maps. But, individual level, like I said, is not what makes or breaks CGL teams or CGL matches. It's teamwork. And no matter how good our relationships were, that sounds wrong, but no matter how well we meshed together as a team, it still wasn't enough. And I think the only thing that can help us improve on that is just time. Time, the weeks and months that filled with scrimming and what a non-stop scrimming and whatever. I think only that can kind of hone our skills as a team if we were to stick together and give us a chance against these other clans. Maybe take a win here or there in future CGL seasons. And that's what you need to realize, is that sometimes no matter how good you are, no matter how good your team is on an individual level, these other teams are just gonna kick your ass just because of the fact that they know how to work as a team way the fuck more than you do. And that's a lesson that I think my team had to learn the hard way. And it sucks, but that's what happened. And we're not sitting here with our thumbs up our asses complaining and bitching about it. We had to take it on the chin, and we had to tell ourselves, hey, look, we got our asses handed to us, but it was a learning experience, and we'll roll with it. And the fact that people are commenting on my video saying that we suck, we haven't even won a single match, and whatever they want to say, I don't think you really appreciate the amount of work that we've done, we put into, improving ourselves as a team. There's no doubt that we have come a long way since first beginning the season number 2 for CGL for Combat Arms. There's no doubt. I can see a huge fucking improvement, not only in my own gameplay, but in the gameplay of my rest of my teammates in general, compared to when we first started out. And some of you guys just don't. The haters, anyway, will never stand a chance to understand it at all. Even if I fucking implore them to, they're never gonna fucking understand. They're not gonna know what it feels like to get on Combat Arms every day at 5 p.m. in the afternoon and scrim for 1, 2, 3, maybe fucking 4 hours at a time. At like 4 or 5 days out of the week, and get better as a team. You don't know that. You really don't know that. If you do, then you're really fucking pathetic, because if you go through that kind of regimen and you still find a reason to hate on us, you are really fucking pathetic. And I have no shame in calling you borderline autistic. You probably are. But, I'd understand if you guys never knew what that feels like. But because of the very reason that you don't know what it feels like to scrim and work hard and, like we have, then don't say anything. Just shut the fuck up. You don't know what we've been through. You don't know what the kind of work and effort that me and my clanmates have put in into our team, into our own skill as a team to get to where we are now. It might not be the most glorious position. It's not exactly started from the bottom, now we're here kind of thing, but it's still something. We still made an improvement. And if you're here to say, oh, you still haven't won a single match, ho ho ho, I don't think you're getting the full picture, honestly. And because you're not getting the full picture, you can go kiss my fucking sorry ass. In fact, you can probably suck my tiny Asian dick, but you can't even do that, so fuck you. Anyways, another thing that really kind of ticks me off about those comments is that, you know, just, I honestly don't think you guys really play Combat Arms or CGL that much. And if you do, then maybe you have a right to say that I suck. Maybe you do have a right to say that our team sucks, because we did go fucking, you know, flawless in terms of getting all our matches as losses. But that wasn't funny. But even then, that's really fucking immature of you. You know, when some guys from the Pissed Clan, you guys probably know who they are because I fucking called them out the other day. But that's, you know, that video is long gone past now. Let's not gonna talk about that. But when some of the guys from the Clan Piss came over to help us out for our match against Team Ego on the map Sandhog, you know, one of them said, I'm very bad with names, so I don't remember who said this, but one of them said, you know, it's fine that you're new, you know, all of us at one point had to start off new, you know, we all had to start out as new CGO players, and it's not necessarily a walk in the park. You're not going to go in there as a newbie, a CGO freshie, and just expect to win games right off the bat. No, that's not how this thing works. If you're new, you need to expect to get, you know, shut down really, really fucking hard. And the only way to prevent yourself from getting, you know, prevent that from ever happening again is just grind it out. Grind it out. And just keep working at it, keep working at becoming a better CGO player, and eventually you'll get to the point where we are. I'm talking from the perspective, you know, whoever helped us from Pissed. You know, we will get on their level, eventually, and it doesn't really matter if how many times we lose. It's about, you know, what we take away from it, and what we learn from our mistakes, and see what we can do to improve. You know, there's always room to improve. There's always, always, always room to improve. So the fact that, you know, people are saying, oh, you know, why are you... Oh, actually, I'll bring up the fucking comments right now. Because I'm fucking heated. I'm roasting you all. Fuck you all. So let me bring up that, that little video here. Sorry if I was silent for a little bit. But yeah, let's see. My CGL Season 2, Week 7, Penis versus V-Seeker. Yeah, this video already has 302 views, or like fucking maybe 6-7 hours after I uploaded it. And already it has 13 likes and 6 fucking dislikes. And just scrolling through the comments right now, just one guy says, you guys lose a lot. Another guy says, the question is, can they win? Oh shit, I accidentally downloaded someone's comment. Oh, what the fuck ever. Another guy says, you guys lose every time. Another guy says, you guys make me sad, did you know? Keep watching, go some fucking retard that I don't know. And don't try to be pro, honestly, how could someone be GOA and be so lame, sad, and A? And, someone else says, you guys lose a lot, no joke. Another guy says, ah, penis sucks, aha, lol, you guys only won was that was a bye. Haha, you kids suck. And things like that. And another guy says, your callouts are awful, and he puts a link that apparently takes me to a community callout guide. Clearly that guy doesn't understand the fact that if everyone understands our callout, everyone on my team understands my callouts, it doesn't really fucking matter what the community callouts are. I mean, fuck, we could have called we called Garage. I'm pretty sure that everyone knows that one. Actually, we made that up ourselves. Maybe it is a community call-out, but I'm not too sure. But when I say garage and factory, maybe that's called something else by other people. But hey, that's what we agreed upon on our call-outs, and that's what we're gonna call it. So shut the fuck up, dude. You know, if you think that call-outs need to be some fucking universal shit, then you are clearly delusional, and you need to shut the fuck up. Because, for all we care, we could have called boilers fucking ass, for all we care. You know, it doesn't have to make sense. It'll help, but it doesn't have to. If I called boilers ass and made sure that everyone on my team said, hey, I'm going to start calling boilers ass, is that okay? And if everyone said, yeah, that's fine, and we start putting that call as ass, then fuck, we'll call it ass all day long and not have anyone know what the fuck we're talking about. It might even be better that way, so people watching these VODs will say, what the fuck is he talking about? So, you know, what does that fucking matter? And, again, that's just being very nitpicky towards one person. But the fact that I need to stare at a wall of, ah ha ha, you suck, you all guys need to quit combat arms, you guys suck, ah ha, you guys suck so much dick, after maybe a month or two of, you know, screaming every single day, practicing every single day about this for CGL, let me tell you what, it ain't exactly encouraging, especially after all that hard work that we've done. By all means, I'm not expecting people to appreciate the work that we put in to improve ourselves. But it's really, really... I can't help but be very annoyed by the fact that, you know, people have to be so fucking flippantly ignorant. Like, rip my fucking hair out level ignorant. And honestly, I don't know who to feel bad for. Myself for not being able to perform better, or for the people who have to watch this video, because either they're fucking retards who don't understand what it means to put in a lot of time into a video game because they think that's completely fucking pointless. I don't know. I really don't know. And, will they ever understand? Probably not. Do I expect them to? Fuck no. They've already proven to me that they're autistic as fuck, so I'm not gonna feel bad or good for them or anything. I'm wasting my fucking time. All I want you guys to know is that we put a lot of time and effort into getting to where we are now, and even if we did lose all the damn time, so the fuck what? So fucking what? It's the fact is that the fun in CGL for me anyway, it's good winning. It definitely feels good winning, yes. But for me, the more important thing is the process in getting there. You know, there's a saying out there that says, you know, a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step, you know, and other quotes like that that describe, like, oh, the process is more important than the end goal, or whatever the fuck. You know, and personally speaking, I do believe that. I honestly feel like the process of getting to where you are now is very enjoyable. It's not, you know, it probably isn't the most comfortable thing. Hell, it's definitely not the best thing. But for me, it's the most enjoyable thing. And a lot of people seem to disagree with me on that. And you guys seem to think that, you know, the end goal is everything. The end goal is, you need to win. You know, you need to fucking win. There's no exception. You need to fucking win. Bro, this is just a fucking video game. What is this? Am I going to kill someone because I lose? No. Like, are you fucking kidding me? We're trying to play to win, but no, there's no getting around that. It would be very nice if we won. But there's a very, very big discrepancy between mentalities here that I can see. That shouldn't really be there. It really shouldn't. It really shouldn't. Because if you know anything about life in general, you know, unless you're like some fucking natural prodigy or something, you know, you're not going to do something off the get-go in that you've never done before and expect to be fucking good at it. No, that's not how this shit works. That's not how life works. If that's how you think life works, then fuck, man. Holy shit, I feel bad for you. How old are you? 26? Oh, man. Oh, shit. Oh man, where are you living? Bottom of the basement of your parents' house? Fuck, man. Oh wait, that probably describes all of you because you're less you haven't gone to college yet. Oh shit. But don't know, man. It's just that it seems like people seem to see all our losses as like that's something to laugh at. Really, dude? You think losing's that bad? You think losing is such a significant deal that you need to feel compelled, you feel compelled to laugh at other people's, losses? We take it like champs, bro. We take it like champs. So, you can laugh all you want at the fact that we may have lost every single game. We don't fucking care. I might because I'm making a fucking video about it, but the rest of my teammates don't fucking care. We all lost our games. Okay, so what? Now we're better players. Now we know what we can work on, what our potential problems are, and we can make it so that, if we do decide to participate in the next season or whatever, then we have a chance. We're no longer newbies. We're no longer freshies. We know what we're doing. We're not total fucking scrubs. We might still lose, but it would be unfair to call us, noobs. It would be definitely unfair. And fuck, man, half the people who keep screaming, "You suck dick," probably have never even played fucking a round of CGL in their entire fucking lives. If you have, well, good fucking luck, getting to where we are now. Good fucking luck. Make your own team and try to take a game off everyone else. I'd love to see you try. And if you do manage to do that, well, good fucking good for you. Good for you. Good for fucking you, 'cause I don't give a shit. Too busy been making money off my own YouTube channel and making myself become better as a CGL player, so I ain't got time to watch your fucking videos, bitch. But in any case, how long have I been talking for? 22 minutes. Again, another long drawn out commentary. But in any case, the thing I want to leave you guys with is that, losing sucks. Yeah, no one wants to lose. But some people, or, sometimes there come times where you just need to bend over and take it like a champ. Because there's nothing really else that you can do. Sometimes you have to lose to win. You have to lose to win. And, this is probably one of the best examples that I probably ever learned in my life that, you're not gonna win everything. Sometimes you're gonna lose everything. Sometimes there comes those times where, hell, well, shit, this kind of sucks. This kind of sucks. And there's nothing I can do about it. Well, technically there is. You know what that is? Keep grinding the game and getting better at it. Because eventually, we're gonna win. We're gonna win something. And winning something is gonna feel really fucking good after all those losses we've been through. You know that? It's gonna feel real fucking good. And I can take that video, put it on my YouTube channel, and say, "Hey guys, we won. So stop saying that we're always losing, 'cause we're now wrong, 'cause we actually won something, motherfuckers. Now shut the fuck up, you autistic bastards." Anyways, probably went off there a little bit too much. So, I'd like to end this commentary because I think I made my point already. So, I'd like to thank you guys very much for watching. It's been a fun season. Probably not a very productive season in terms of getting wins or anything, but it was fun nonetheless. And like I said, the process of getting to where we are now, the experience of going through all the practice, playing all the matches, is more fun than, to me anyway, at least for right now, than, worrying constantly about, "Oh, we need to win this match. We need to fucking win this match. We have to win. We can't afford to lose." 'Cause to be honest with you, I don't wanna stress myself over, the fact that we have to win a fucking game. I stress myself over enough, scrimming and trying to make myself better. That's where the stress is at. And I'm not gonna waste my fucking life away stressing over whether or not we're gonna win our next match. We're gonna fucking play. If we win, we win. If we lose, we lose. End of the story. And we might feel good about ourselves if we win. We might feel bad about ourselves if we lose. At the end of the day, playing is what I'm there for. You know, having fun playing CGL's combat is what I'm there for, because like I said before, if you're not playing a video game to enjoy it, you're doing it fucking wrong. You are doing it fucking wrong. Go do something else if you're not having fun playing a video game, because that's what video games are meant for. Unless it's like an educational video game or something, then you can be miserable. But if it's for a game like Combat Arms, if it's a game that you enjoy playing, the moment that you stop, you know, having fun with it or whatever, is the moment or is the instant that you need to get the fuck off and do something else and come back to it later when you know you can have fun with it. I had fun with it all the way through. So that's why I kept playing. And I kept losing. And it sucked. Yeah. But I'm not going to take it from people like you. People like the fucking internet trolls on the internet. Especially with the toxic ass commenters community. That's probably one of the worst communities out there in the fucking internet. Especially not from you guys. I'm not going to take it. So fuck off, and let me enjoy my own CGL experience in peace. Like, please. Please fuck off. But people aren't going to listen to me, so oh well. You know? Oh well. You know? Boo-hoo me. You know, people aren't going to leave me alone. Oh, wah-wah-wah-wah-wah. Yeah, whatever. You know, I'm going to keep doing what I do. You might not want to see it. It's your fucking fault. And keep watching the views, you know? All the views that I get, it gives me money because you click on it. It gives me fucking YouTube revenue. So if you say, if you really think that I suck, don't watch my fucking videos. Then that way I don't have to deal with your bullshit. Jesus Christ, man. But in any case, it's late at night. I'm cranky as fuck. I need to go to sleep. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you everyone that we've, not only that we've scrimmed, and played in CGL matches, but my own teammates for, you know, being good guys. All of you guys are good guys, man. All of you guys are good guys. And, you know, thanks a lot for bringing me along for a ride. Thank you guys a lot. And hopefully you can do this again. Hopefully. So, and with preferably wins this time, so we can shut the haters up. But, yeah, regardless, it was a fun ride for season number 2. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens with the later seasons and later months come. So, I want to thank everyone for listening/watching the commentary, and we'll see you guys later sometime in a future commentary that I'll do. So, again, thank you guys very much for watching, and we will see you guys later.